If it were possible, I've been told that His Royal Highness the Prince of Wales is utterly disgusted with the recent behaviour of his much younger brother, some people might suggest, maybe in years, maybe not in years, but actually in brains perhaps, of course, the former royal known as Prince Harry, the Duke of Sussex. Let me explain. Morning, how are you? Nice to see you. Thank you so much. Now listen, yeah, a fascinating story as we now know with this particular sort of debacle really. I think that's the only thing that you could say. Because when you think about it, Harry seemingly is just taking himself down a barrel of absolute disasters, isn't it? You know, popping up in the Las Vegas thing, the John Travolta flying award thing, which means absolute nonsense, the rebranding of course, the Sussex website. What's all of this about, you know? You do kind of think this guy clearly has not got enough to do. But of course, when you think about it, it all is badly reflected, as many people agree, over here on the British royal family. It's all very well, you know, His Majesty the King and of course Queen Camilla just dismissing it and moving on. In this generation, it's truly not enough. Things stick, they're played out on social media, and more than ever, you know, both William and Catherine understand this format, perhaps more than His Majesty the King and of course Queen Camilla. And let's not forget, His Majesty has one or two problems of his own right now, of which we wish him all the very best. But you see, the bigger problem now is with Harry basically openly lying and saying things that his lawyers allowed to do. This does reflect incredibly badly over here. You know, it's just hard to imagine, because now when you go on a royal walkabout, people are not as deferential as they were, say, 20, 30 years ago, and will simply ask him, what do you think about your brother lying? William's all too aware of that. And what's interesting, what I've been told about this particular aspect of the story is, as you know, Harry's lawyer is basically saying whatever he said in his book is not necessarily true, and there's so many other elements that we now know never happened at all. You know, the fact that Meghan herself played herself as a victim from the moment she arrived in Kensington, and always made sure that she was there, you know, literally playing the victimhood, which in turn turned around that bullying accusation and claim. You see those problems. Now, of course, William, I've been told, doesn't really know which way to turn, because everything really in the end falls down to His Majesty the King. And we can't really put too much pressure on him. You know, a lot of people want the titles removed, and indeed, William and Catherine basically know this. You know, they know the mood of the public. But you see, the bigger picture is this, and this is one that clearly Prince Harry truly doesn't care about. He knows, along with William, the true stories that Harry has written about in that book, particularly about his time in the army. Nobody knows those stories more succinctly and in more great detail than Prince William. And it's fascinating to note that Harry's allowing this particular line to go out there in the public domain, because obviously, like we all do, we know that the royals can't necessarily hit back. It's not the thing that they can do. It wouldn't really be perceived as nice by the public. But these stories have a strange way of getting out into the public domain. And William, I've been told, is absolutely steaming at this new, shall we say, directive of Harry's team. Basically put out the book, and then to get out of something else, claim, of course, it wasn't true. The bigger issue now facing Harry is his forthcoming American visa documentation and where that will lead. If, of course, the judge decides that he now needs to look further into this, it could be catastrophic, not just for Harry, but of course the reputational damage of the British monarchy. And Prince William knows all too well how damaging that can be for other senior royals. Neil Sean in the very heart of London.